And also on saving endangered species. In addition, he went up to Philippines at Philippines Eagle Center for Community Conservation Project, which is about saving Philippines eagles. He has been invited by Denver Zoo, US for radio telemetry scientific research expedition for Cenarius Vulture Project, and have been to Thailand, Indonesia, Russia for various such projects. So we have a guest lecturer who has dynamic experience in biodiversity conservation. Welcome again, sir. And I request to start with the webinar.
Yes. Yeah, it's my great pleasure to join with you. Thanking you for giving me an opportunity for Urunam Samstha, I think so. I had a phone from Manasri Bapat, who is working over there, and she called me for this webinar within a couple of days. And we are back from Vulture Census Program, which have been held for the very first time in District Raigad, Maharashtra. We have counted whiteback vulture and longbill vulture, these two species. And later we analyzed the data and observed the drop of population because of Nisarga cyclone and as well the problem of COVID. Hello?
Yes, sir.
Can you hear me?
Yes, yes.
Yes, okay. So today we will see how the vultures are doing and in what way we are supposed to conserve the endangered species. All of you know very well about the habitat destruction problems and various pollutions and temperature, climate changes. Everywhere we see very serious problems which are really frontiers with our day-to-day life. And for that, our SISCAP NGO, Society for Eco Endangered Species Conservation and Protection, working on the conservation of such endangered species as well as their critical habitat, which is now in danger. So previously, we have started this work in 1994, where we have surveyed from 1994 to 1996 in Konkan area. And we were about to hold Pakshimitra Sammelana, Konkan Pakshimitra Sammelana. Bhau Kadare have told me about to conduct a second Pakshimitra Sammelana in Raigad district and especially in Mahad. And so to collect the data about the birds and to publish one checklist, we have really surveyed so many pockets where at that time there were vultures colony, especially I remember from Pali region. In Pali, there is Thanali Leni, means the caves, and uplift at caves, there were, I think, 20 to 30 nests were there. And to the cliff of this Pali fort, Sudagad, there were nearly 20 nests I have counted. And then the Kondana side, or Kondala Leni, and the Kondgao area, which is back of the Pali, and to the baseline of Tailbela fort. So there were also longbill vultures nest. I always came across while doing rappelling or mountaineering activities. Those were very beautiful days. I still remember. We were used to swim in river because that time it was not polluted that much. And nowadays it is become very brackish and hard to hard to go in the river. It is very polluted. If you go in the river and you will see some allergic reactions on your skin. So unfortunately, what we left now for the next generation is the fact about everything is polluted and masked. And so the days are remembering from 1999, where we read one article in Times of India, which was published by BNHS and co-authored by RSPB, Royal Society for Protection of Birds and BirdLife International, and funded program by Peregrine Fund. So these three NGOs from European countries, they are funded for vulture census in Pakistan as well as in Gujarat, Rajasthan, and found out in Kevladev National Park. that there is sudden drop or decline of the vulture population, and it goes to 99.8%, and we were shocked at that time. So what had happened actually to these vultures? Let's see. And then we started our survey in our area, Raigad district, where there were various pockets, devarais, means the sacred forest, and the grooves, which have means the shady forest, and the water springs like areas where we have previously seen so many nests. To the Masala forest, we went up and see there were empty colonies. The colonies were deserted, and in also many areas about the Raigad periphery, there were no single bird have been observed, and it was simply shock for us too. Then from that moment, we started our work to in seek of searching in the colony of the presence of these majestic wings or these birds. White-back vultures are the tree nestlers. Next slide, please. Next slide, yeah. So such a hovering picture or such a soaring flock of birds which have been observed. Very, yes, you may say few numbers, only 11 to 12 or 5 or 20 might be. So I've seen them in Raigad area in the afternoon and took this snap. And from this population, very short population, we got confident about that still there are chances to see this very much big size and a huge bird. So vultures, as you know it very well, in previous stories, each village was supported by vulture colony or vulture population. When the villagers they throw their carcasses to their dumping ground, in our area, such a dumping grounds are called as dhor taki. Dhor means the bulls, cows, or whatever, the livestock, and on which ground they are throwing these carcasses, it is called as dhor taki. So on such a dhor taki, we went up and took some data about having interview with villagers as well as head of the villages. Then some old people who have seen in their childhood the flocks or the number of vultures. And also personally, I've been for so many times of the vulture in Mahad, my city. And many other places like in Dasgaon, where the common market was being called after 15 days. And in that various villages, they brought their livestock to sell. Just like sheep or goats or these bulls or cows and all that, buffaloes. So went up to so many places. We have seen the deserted these feeding grounds or the dhor takis, and then we concluded that really there are absence of such a birds. Next slide, please. Next slide, please. Ma'am, next slide, please.
Yes, sir. It is getting a little bit time to
change. Ah, okay. Okay. So these birds, those have been observed in forest as well as on the, you may say, top of our roof-like table land from high mountain of our beautiful range of Sahyadri. Sahyadri ranges runs from Pali region to Raigad, and from Tamini to Raigad, and from Raigad to Bhor, then Mahabaleshwar, and down to Savantwadi. You can see such a beautiful scenic view of having up and down views of these scenic mountains. And in a couple of mountain or in between two mountain ranges there, you can see a resting cloud, a white spot of cloud. So such a spot of heighted 1,800 to 1,200 to 2,800 feet in high. Such a valleys are decorated with well vegetation of having tall trees which are competing in this forest. As you can see, the wall of these mountains front of you, when they are falling, their shade is actually fallen down to the valley deep to that base side or baseline. So that is called as shady forest. And in the shady forest, the trees are competing with each other and growing taller and taller. saw on such a tall trees and treetop, you can see a very huge cup of or a very huge nest of such a vultures or raptors like eagles, especially the crested hawk eagle, crested serpent eagle, or maybe if it is connected with the coastal area, then you would also have a chance to see a majestic wing of sea eagle. So in such a way, these all big raptors, they are making their nest on such a tower trees, on the top of that tower trees. So we lost within these two decades, such a deep valley tall trees forest. Because the mining is going on, then the farming of cashew nut trees as well as mango trees, this cash crop have been planted by many farmers. And so that we are losing this battle on clock hours. Next slide, please. So this is the slide from Mahabaleshwar top we have seen. Yes, it is taking time, I think so. Next slide, please.
Yes, it's taking a little bit
time. Okay. So whenever I used to do slideshow in colleges and schools, I told students to do observation while on travel in Ghat, Western Ghat, to cross the this Konkan land to go to the upside, to Pune or to other areas. When they are crossing such valleys, they can sight easily the flight of or the flock of birds. And when they convey me by phone or from other media that while on traveling to Pune by Tamini Ghat or while on traveling to Mahabaleshwar by Polatpur Ghat, we observed such a 5 to 6 huge birds flock. And getting that information, we used to rush up to that site and we check the site of that hilly or whatever the forest we can see on that spot, according to informate. And reaching to that spot, we came to know about such a lush green, semi-evergreen forest, just like in this picture. You can see this is the this picture is taken from Srivardhan, one of the valley forest. From Maslar to Srivardhan, the road is crossing 4 to 5 valleys, and it was very scenic valley where you can see towards left side to the brown ridge of this hillock, there is a black spot. So that was vulture actually, and maybe it has the colonial habitation to this area. And this valley forest is now have been lost by last few years doing some activity of coconut or mango farming or some other chikus like cashew crops they have been planted. This is all private yarn which was really decorated with good vegetation, having mixed wild trees, the endemic trees, tall trees, as well as evergreen and deciduous trees. You can see the mixed line. So such a valleys are of utmost importance for vulture roosting as well as nesting sites. So you may have chance to see any presence or roost of vultures or any raptors in such a valleys, surely. But we have lost nearly 60 to 80% of such a valley forest nowadays. While on traveling from highway to Goregaon or Mangaon to Srivardhan or Divyagar coastal line, whatever the forest was there, it was now under threat. And because of deforestation, that habitat have lost very delicate or you may say very crucial link of all these scavengers, animals like hyenas, then jackals, fox, or the pangolin, like a very critically endangered animal. Next slide, please. So this is typical sacred forest. And once you are in search of such a presence of raptor, if you spend a full day in such a valley or tree or top line of that valley, you may say the tower observation spot, go to the top of that hill and just have see below your eye line, whatever the forest is there. And during day observation, surely during breeding season, you can see either the bird is flying from valley towards outside to the campus, or otherwise in the late evening or in the afternoon when these bird are carrying the food material, they are entering from outside from any periphera to that forest which is under your observation. So such a flight pay your attention or catch your attention, and it is very important to note its flight, its direction, and then follow it very seriously. That time you must have to see how and where this bird is going, what way it carry it in its crop, the food material, or what else the things. Next slide, please. So this picture was taken in 2000, where this bird entered in this forest. This is the forest of Chirgaon, a typical evergreen patch of the shady forest, which is supported by a spring. The river name is Chirgaon. The Chirgaon river is originated from this place. So this is the beginning of that spring, where you can see this picture are taken by month of May, and the green tree you can see, the green leafy water vegetation you can see, and at the center you will notice the spots. 4 to 5 spots are there, black spots are there. Those are vulture. Vultures are roosted there. So when I follow that flight of one vulture in the late evening, and see going through that lush green forest, we have noticed these 4 to 5 birds. And इथे आम्ही खूप आनंदित झालो. It was overwhelmed. That moment was very much खूप तो इतका जबरदस्त आनंद होता की जवळपास 1.5 वर्ष आम्ही त्या शोधात होतो. वी आर डेस्परेटली इन सर्च ऑफ ऍटलीस्ट अ सिंगल बर्ड, अँड इट वॉज द बर्ड इन फ्रंट ऑफ मी विच वॉज टूक मी टू हिज रूस्टिंग ॲज वेल द नेस्टिंग साईट्स वेअर देअर लास्ट प्रेझेन्स ऑर देअर लास्ट स्ट्रगल फॉर एक्झिस्टन्स वर गोईंग ऑन. सो वी वेअर सिम्पली यु नो वी गेट ओव्हरवेल्म अँड जॉइस टू सी दिस बर्ड. And then there was the village. Next slide, please. This is the spring or the waterfall. Chirgaon River originates from this waterfall. At the end of this slide, how the river it goes 18 kilometer and how it enters to the creek line of Masla Creek, that we will see. But this is the beginning of this river, and this picture was taken in 2000, and now current year, whatever the white portion of that fall you can see, it is shrinking to only 1 feet. It was 4.8 feet broad at that time, and now we are losing day by day the water part, because to the upper side where the catchment area of this waterfall is there, it was now destructed for colonial construction or development of new projects from builders, as well as new farms are being in process. So they have cut down 150 acre land, just like the patches of somehow 20 acres land, 40 acres land like that. And we have lose the buttress root plants, which have hold as much water during the rainy season, and they loosen the water during the summer season, and because of that, these soils or this waterfall, it lives and it carries that water to downstream. So this is the unique line, and in such a way, if you all are about to visit such a place in Masla, still there are 6 water holes or water resources which are still just flowing in the same way, but carrying somehow little water because of the deforestation or the destruction what have been taken or what have been carried since last 1.5 decade. So such a water holes are very important because they are maintaining the temperature up to 22 to 28 max. And so in such a valleys, the vultures used to roost or used to nest their colonies. Next slide, please. So this is Chirgaon waterfall. And when we generally used to stay at that place where we see the last flight of bird or roost in the late evening. So naturally, I stay over there in the village. I request a village head, Mr. Kishore Gulgule, who will be in the next slide, I think so. And I request him to keep me stay for one night there. And he allowed me. And then in the morning, I took him to his forest, sacred forest. And I show him the presence of vultures. He was simply denied at that time in the night when we will have chat. That he was just denying the presence of vultures in his own yard, the sacred forest, which was behind that small, you know, colony of that villagers. So I told him, and I took him in the morning, and I show him the presence of vultures, and we have noticed two species there. Whatever the brown or off-white color birds, little bit bigger in size, you can see in the pictures. Those are long-bill vultures. Long-bill vultures, their scientific name is Gyps indicus. And in Marathi, it is called as Lam Tochicha Gidad. And it's a chan badami rangache, don gidad tumhala disatay. Eka dave side picture jya, tyachyamadhye te pankha pasarvtana disatay. And nantar ghetlela photo, tyane pankha parat mitavle ani position badalli. So these two pictures also have been taken in the same year, 2000, where we found this colony of 18 birds at that time we noticed. And then the black in color, kaalya rangache je ahet, those are white back vultures. Tyanna apan pandrya patiche gidar mhanto. The scientific name of that white back vulture is Gyps bengalensis. आणि त्यांना मराठीमध्ये आपण पांढऱ्या पाठीचं गिधाड असं म्हणतो, किंवा गावातली त्याला काळा ढोका गिधाड असं म्हणतात त्या स्थानिक भाषेमध्ये. काळ्या ढोकाची गिधाड आणि ही सफेद ढोकाची गिधाड, तर गावाला भरपूर माहिती आहे. दे नो द वाईल्ड लाईफ व्हेरी किनली बिकॉज दे आर फ्रॉम दॅट सॉईल अँड दे नो देअर नेस्टिंग प्लेस. सो दे टोल्ड मी दॅट दीज ऑफ व्हाईट कलर वल्चर्स दे आर व्हिजिटर्स. ते म्हणे पाहुण्यात आमच्याकडचे, ते आपल्याकडे घरट करत नाही. सो दे आर नॉट ट्री नेस्टलेस इन अवर एरिया अँड दोज आर गोईंग समवेअर वी डोंट नो. अँड ओनली ब्लॅक वल्चर्स दे आर रोस्टिंग अँड डुईंग नेस्ट इन अवर एरिया. सो त्यांना खूप चांगलं माहिती आहे, दे नो व्हेरी वेल, की हे दोन्ही जे वल्चर्स आहेत, लॉंगबिल वल्चर्स आणि पांढऱ्या पाठीची गिधाड, त्यापैकी ही काळी रंगाची जी आहेत, त्यांना आपण पांढऱ्या पाठीची गिधाड असं म्हणतो, ते आपल्या इथे जंगलामध्ये झाडावर घरट करतात. सो व्हाईट बॅक वल्चर्स और व्हाईट रम्प वल्चर्स आर ट्री नेस्लर्स. आपण कावळ्याचं जसं घरट बघतो, जसं टिपिकल काड्या घेऊन आपण घरट बांधलेलं बघतो, इन द सेम वे दीज बर्ड्स आर कलेक्टिंग स्टिक्स और समहाउ ब्रेकिंग स्टिक्स ऑफ बेहडा, देन अर्जुना लाईक ट्रीज, सातवीण आहेत त्याच्यामध्ये, मँगो आहे, शेडाम आहे, अशा वेगळ्या 14-15 प्रकारच्या झाडांची काठ्या उचलतात आणि ते त्यांचं मोठं घरट बनवतात. आणि वन्स दे पेअर विथ फिमेल और मेल, एकदा त्यांनी पेअरिंग केलं की दॅट पेअर रिमेन्स लाईफ लॉंग, ती जोडीदार कायम आयुष्यभर राहतातच. आणि द घरट म्हणजे ते जे नेस्ट आहे, इट ऑल्सो दे यूज टाइम बाय टाइम द रिपेअर, दॅट इज ऑल्सो लॉंग लास्टिंग. ते पण बदलत नाही शक्यतो, अनलेस दे वर नॉट sense it in danger or otherwise feel it in danger. So badami rangachi ji gidad ahet, lam tochi ji gidad ji ahet na, ti chhan ashi kadya madhe gharat karatat. So from Shivtargad you see the mountain cliffs which are flat or doing right angle, the wall is doing right angle to exact this landform down to the hillock region or hill region. सो बरोबर असं 90° कोन करणाऱ्या उभ्या दगडाच्या भिंती आहेत. तर पाली दगड सगळ्यांनी बघितलेलं आहे आपल्या, पाली अँड कोंडगाव अँड टेलबेला फोर्ट, ऑल ऑफ यू आर अवेअर ऑफ द क्लिफ इमेज इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू. किती स्टीप आणि सरळ, अगदी आपण ओळंबा लावला तर ओळंब्याच्या बरोबर लाईनने जशी वॉल असते, समवेअर द वॉल हॅव बीन ऑब्झर्व हॅव्हिंग ओव्हरहँग, म्हणजे असा एक आत कर्व गेलेला असतो, ज्याला टांगतीत भिंत पण आपण दगडाचे म्हणू शकतो. तर अशा प्रकारच्या भिंती ह्या हे लॉंगबिल वल्चर्स यूज करतात. अँड दोज आर क्लिफ नेस्लर्स. सो लॉंगबिल वल्चर्स ते क्लिफमधले जे ग्रूव्स असतात, खाचा असतात दगडांच्या, किंवा खळगे असतात असे छान, सो होल्स आर देअर नॅचरली, तर त्या होल्समध्ये हे आपलं घरट करतात. द नेस्ट इज व्हेरी सिम्पल, मेल ब्रॉट 5 to 6 स्टोन्स, समहाऊ द ड्रॉप ऑफ मड and putting on its droppings over that. He painted that area, and then he brings also sometimes shells or sticks. चार पाच स्टिक्स आणतो आणि तिथे ठेवतो. फिमेल खुश होते आणि मग ती त्याला पसंती दर्शवते. अँड देन द फर्दर प्रोसेस टेक्स प्लेस अँड द ब्रीडिंग स्टार्ट्स. सो अशा प्रकारे सुंदर असं त्यांचं ते छान घरट असतं. मात्र हे लॉंगबिलचे वल्चरचे जे नेस्ट आहेत ही दोज आर ॲट हाईट ऑफ 1800 feet. आपण 1800 feet ते 3000-4000 feet जी दगडाची कातळी लाईन बघितली, खास करून कोकण कडापड समोर राहणार, रायगडच्या मागे टकमुक टोकाची भिंत आहे. सो दॅट वॉल ऑल्सो यू कॅन इमॅजिन इफ यू स्टँड टू द नॉर्दर्न साइड ऑफ रायगड फोर्ट अँड वॉट एव्हर टू द वारंगी रेंज रिजन यू कॅन सी द वॉल्स टुवर्ड्स द लिंगाणा फोर्ट विच इज एक्झॅक्टली बॅकफूट ऑफ रायगड. रायगडच्या बरोबर मागे लिंगाणा फोर्ट आहे आणि ते लिंगाणा फोर्ट इट हॅज अ लिंगाणा वॉल. मोठी तिथे वॉल आहे उंच अशी आणि जवळपास 700-800 feet ती वॉल आहे. खूप सुंदर अशी वॉल आहे आणि त्याच्यामध्ये पण नॅचरल होल मध्ये नेस्ट आहे. सो एव्हरीवेअर की जिथे जिथे अशा प्रकारच्या वॉल्स आहेत, इवन नाशिकच्या रेंजमध्ये आहेत, इकडे जाताना वेगळ्या माउंटेन रेंजेस जे आहेत वाड्यावरून पुढे त्या रेंजमध्ये देखील ते आहेत. सो अशा वॉलच्या ठिकाणीच अशा प्रकारचे लॉंगबिल वॉल्चर्स नेस्ट करतात. नेक्स्ट साइड प्लीज. सो देर इज अ मिक्स पॉप्युलेशन ऑफ LBB दॅट इज लॉंगबिल वॉल्चर अँड WBB दॅट इज व्हाईट बॅक वॉल्चर. So this is typical a colony of a white back vulture on the tree of Terminalia bellarica. Behedacha zhaad asel hi chhan colony hai. So behedacha zhaad uncha vadta aplyakade aajhi aamchyakade mahad cha aaspas kahi devaryan madhe khup uncha uncha 110-140 feet itki uncha devaryatle zhaad hai behedachi. But nowadays what had happened is the reformation of those sacred temples those have been taken place in every villages. The village are apply they are doing application to some construction department of our jila parishad or jila tehsil and they get grant of 2.5 crore rupees and those grant they are using to break the old beautiful त्याला कौलारूप घर आपण असं म्हणतो. सो ते घर, ते देवळाचं घर ते तोडतात अँड दे आर बिल्डिंग द सिमेंट कॉन्क्रीट डबल स्टोरे टेम्पल्स अँड फॉर दॅट दे आर गेटिंग ग्रांट्स इमिजिएटली अँड दे आर बिल्डिंग हॉल फॉर डिफरंट पर्पजेस अँड सो डिस्ट्रक्टिंग बिग ट्रीज लाईक बेहड्याचे पण आहेत, हिरड्याचे आहेत, त्याच्यानंतर मोठी अशी सातवणीची झाडं आहेत. सो बिवळा आहे, वावळ आहे, अशा प्रकारची उंच जी झाड आहेत, ती झाड आहेत, अर्जुनाची झाड आहेत, ती सगळी ह्या देवराईच्या नूतनीकरणामध्ये ती सगळी तोडतात. आणि व्हॉट दे ब्रॉड देअर इट इज अ पेवर ब्लॉक. म्हणजे पेवर ब्लॉकचा असं मस्त पाथ करतात. दे बिल्ट अप न्यू रोड, सिमेंट रोड असतात, टार रोड असतात. सो दोज ऑल दॅट पेवर ब्लॉक्स द रूप ऑफ मेटल शीट ऑर सिमेंट गॉस शीट ऑर द स्टील ऑर सिमेंट कन्स्ट्रक्शन इज ऑल रिस्पॉन्सिबल टू इन्क्रीज द temperature of that typical sacred forest which results to get affected on the bark of that trees where there were lichens or there were the mosses or the hanging heritage of our tropical rainforest. Those are nothing but the orchids. So ultimately slowly the forest loses its biodiversity and so ultimately the bird too left that places. So in such a way, we are restoring and rebuilding such a or repairing such a habitat. Since 20 years, we are collecting the seeds of such a behda, hirada, and then arjuna, devbhavula, avar, like tall trees. And then we have nurseries where we grow these trees for 2 years. And getting the height of 10 feet above, then we took that plant and for plantation. So in such a way, काय त्याच्यामध्ये 100% guarantee there is a good potential to have root those trees. They have strong ability to So अशा प्रकारे collect the seeds from that sacred forest only, and again plant the trees to the same forest. So अशीच आपण method केली तर foreign seed तिथे येणार नाही आणि ती टिपिकल जीन्स आहे तिथला विच हॅव कॉम्पिट सिन्स मेनी इयर्स अँड डेव्हलप्ड ऑर यु मे अडॉप्ट टू दॅट एरिया. तर तो जीन्स अँड टी सीड्स खूप छान जगू शकते आणि वाढू शकते. नेक्स्ट स्लाइड प्लीज. So this is typical population of whiteback on this is the Chirgaon village. This all sacred forest of Chirgaon is belongs to this Chirgaon village. To the left side, to the blue range, you can see only 7 to 10 houses, where to the right side there are 6 houses. So 16 gharacha he gaav samplo ithe asta gayat rasta navta. Gele 5 varshamade jara rasta ala, 5-10 varshamade. आणि मग तो मातीचा रस्ता आजही आहे. तिथे चिखलात पावसाळी रस्ता बंद असतो, जाता येत नाही, त्यामुळे ह्या गावाला पावसाळ्यात ऍक्सेस नाही. सो सच अनटेन विलेज जो आहे त्याच्यामध्ये तो, त्याच्यामुळे तो कुठल्याही फॅसिलिटीमुळे फॅसिलिटी पासून जरा थोडा दूर आहे. पण गेल्या काही याच्यापासून जमिनीचे ज्या सेल आउटचे जे प्रकार वाढले तर त्या प्रकारामध्ये या गावामध्ये रस्ते जरा बऱ्यापैकी होऊन गाड्या यायला लागलेल्या आहेत. आणि त्या सगळ्या जंगलामध्ये जंगलतोड होऊन ते उघडे बोडके सगळे एरिया व्हायला लागले. सो अशा प्रकारे विलेजर्स आहेत हे लोकल, ते मात्र त्यांच्या स्वतःच्या जमिनी ज्या त्या आणि या सॅक्रेड फॉरेस्टवर खूप नजर ठेवून आहेत. गेली जवळपास 20 वर्ष चिरगावची विलेजेस, त्याच्यानंतर भापटची विलेजेस विलेजर्स आहेत ती, आणि चिरगाव सडकेची वाडी आहे ती, दहेन, या सगळ्या पंचकृषीतल्या गावकऱ्यांनी गिधाड वाचवा म्हणून स्वतःला या कामामध्ये झोकून दिलं. सो आवर कन्झर्वेशन वर्क मस्ट बी विथ दीज विलेजर्स, इट शुड बी कम्युनिटी कन्झर्वेशन लेवल. तर आपण जर या कम्युनिटीशी राहू, त्यांच्याबरोबर त्यांची सुखदुःख जाणून घेऊ आणि त्यांच्याबरोबर जर आपण त्यांच्याशी राहून त्यांना मदत करू, देन अँड देअर दे गेट कॉन्फिडंट अबाउट युअर वर्क अँड युअर प्रेझेन्स अँड युअर वॉट एव्हर यू आर डुईंग ऍक्टिव्हिटीज, दे आर रिअली टेकिंग पार्ट फ्रॉम बॉटम ऑफ देअर हार्ट. सो दिस इज द टिपिकल लाईव्ह स्टॉक यू कॅन सी. काऊज आहेत, त्याच्यामध्ये छोटे काफ आहेत, ती छान म्हातारी त्यांना सगळ्यांना आणते. तर असं सकाळ संध्याकाळ तुम्हाला चित्र दिसेल. गाव एवढंच आहे पण चार वाड्यात त्या ठिकाणी, जिथे जवळपास 150 जास्त गुरं आहेत. मात्र आता कोविडच्या याच्यामुळे आणि आधीच्या याच्यामुळे, शिवाय मुलं पण मोठी झाली की ज्याच्यामुळे हे आता गुरं ढोरांचे व्यवसाय बंद पडायला लागले, शेती बंद पडले. सो स्लोली दिस लाईव्ह स्टॉक इज गेटिंग श्रिंकन. नेक्स्ट आहे प्लीज. सो तिथे इलेक्ट्रिसिटी आता काही वर्षातच आली आहे, पण गेल्या ज्या वादळामध्ये हे मागचं जे आपलं घर आहे, शाळा आहे, ते शाळेवर झाड पूर्ण पडून ते पूर्णपणे कोलॅप्स झालेले, आता ते आता अस्तित्वात नाहीये. सो दिस वॉज द प्रायमरी स्कूल वेन आय वॉज अबाउट टू लिव्ह देअर. आय टूक डिसिजन टू स्पेंड माय 3 years टू लिव्ह इन द विलेज अँड टू स्टडी द वल्चर्स अँड टू रेज द कन्झर्वेशन ऍक्टिव्हिटीज अलॉंग दॅट पेरिफेरी ऑफ ऑल द विलेजेस. 62 विलेजेस आर देअर, ज्यामध्ये आपला हा प्रोजेक्ट त्यावेळी काम करत होता. आणि मग इथे मी या शाळेमध्येच सुंदर अशा राहिलो की ज्याच्यातली चिमुकली विद्यार्थी आहेत सगळे, खूप मस्त विद्यार्थी आहेत. तुम्ही त्यांच्या चेहऱ्यावरचा आनंद बघा, भारी रे. इथून गावातून काही जण चालत येतात बाहेरून, तर काही जण इथेच राहतात गावातले. सो इथे एक युनिफॉर्म नसलेली मुलगी आहे, सगळ्यात छोटी, छान टपोरे डोळे आहेत तिचे. सो ती मुलगी आहे, तिच्या शेजारी जो आहे तो सुशांत, ती छाया अंडा सुशांत. सो तो सुशांत जो आहे तो सरपंचांचा मुलगा, विलेज हेड जे आहेत किशोर गुलगुले, हिज वन ऑफ द बेस्ट सन, हिज नेम इज सुशांत. आणि मग सुशांतला मी काय केलं, तो जसा मोठा झाला तसा त्याला गिधाड बघायला शिकवलं, अर्थात सगळ्यांना शिकवलं. सगळी मुलं खरी ते सायंटिस्ट आहेत, त्यांना माहिती आहे कुठे पक्षी उडतात, कुठे जातात. दे नो व्हेरी वेल वेन द वल्चर्स आर बास्किंग, वेन द वल्चर्स यूज टू व्हिजिट रिव्हर बँक, दे आर क्लिनिंग देअर फेदर्स अँड दे आर टेकिंग बाथ फ्रॉम दॅट रिव्हर वॉटर ऑन रॉकी बँक. सो दे नो एव्हरी मोमेंट ऑफ द वल्चर्स बिकॉज दे फॉलो दॅट पाथ, फूड पाथ, अँड बाय विच दे आर कमिंग टू स्कूल अँड देन अगेन दे आर ट्रॅव्हलिंग टू जंगल अँड गोईंग टू देअर होम. सो अशा प्रकारची खूप सुंदरी टीम. नेक्स्ट, हेच आपलं जुनं सेस्केपचं ऑफिस होतं. नेक्स्ट स्लाइड प्लीज. सो ही सुंदर टीम अशी मी त्यांना सगळ्यांना स्लाइड शो करून दाखवला. आणि त्याच घराला किंवा त्याच शाळेला आपलं सिस्केप स्टडी रिसर्च अँड कॉन्झर्वेशन सेंटर असं आपण सेंटरचा बोर्ड ठोकून दिला. सो यू हॅव स्टार्टेड अवर सेंटर वर्क, रिसर्च वर्क ओव्हर हियर. first, and then second to the couple of months, within couple of months, we have launched to the Srivardhan area, and third one, which have been launched to the Vadgar area, and fourth one to the Nanimachi area for long bill vulture, fifth one to Pali area, to the region of Kondgaon, and sixth one to the Khamgaon, the forest or the Chirga, the forest which is concerned with Masala area. So Asha Prakare, Srivardhan, Masala, Tejarantar, Vadgar, Vagar, Sagya area madhe Asha Prakarche apan study centers form kele. What is actually the work of study center? So it is nothing but to get rent on rent one room or house from that village where the birds are there, where the critically endangered species are there. Kiva chhan jungle ante jungle apala vasvayche tya ti jaga apan nivadto, and there we are launching our this project where tumcha sarkya shaharamadun, Pune madun, Mumbai madun, Garhware college madun, Thana college madun, jithe वाटवे सर होते किंवा गरवारे कॉलेजचे आत्ताचे सगळे स्टाफ आहे, तो ठाण्याच्या पेजवार मॅडम आहेत, त्या त्याच्यानंतर कुरवे मॅडम आहेत, आपल्या मोरुपारे कॉलेजला एरागी सर होते, विल्सन कॉलेजचे सर आहेत, त्याच्यानंतर कोकणातल्या आपल्या कुलकर्णी सर आहेत, आपल्या याला चिप रत्नागिरीच्या गोगटे जोगळेकर कॉलेजला. सो वी हॅव कनेक्टेड विथ 14 कॉलेजेस वेअर दी एमएससी बाय रिसर्च स्टुडंट्स they are enrolling their dissertation activity with us, and we guide them to teach the baseline of all project work or whatever the dissertation they have noted regarding the vultures or the forest birds or any other raptors. So ya hacha madhe ma ami sagal kitchen vagere thevto, mate mule yeun tithe rahatat, to staying facility, vachavantar villages contact, tyanchyashi olakh, so secure everything policy. सो असं सगळं असेल छान. आणि मग आपण रेग्युलर तिथे ऑब्झर्वेशन करायला ऑब्झर्वर असतात. सो हा सुशांत आहे जो छोटा असा, तुम्ही सुशांत बघितला होता तो, आणि त्याच्यानंतर पुन्हा एक आठ वर्ष चार वर्षांनी घेतलेला साधारण फोटो आहे, तो जेव्हा आठवीत होता तेव्हा सुशांत आपला ऑब्झर्वेशन रेग्युलर करायचा, त्याची वही माझ्याकडे आजही आहे. सो सुशांत यूज टू रोट डायरी अबाउट हिज मॉर्निंग अँड इव्हनिंग ऑब्झर्वेशन दॅट फाईव्ह बर्ड्स हे ऑब्झर्व ऑन सिटिंग टर्मिनालिया बेलारिका ट्री टर्मिनल अर्जुना ट्री लाईक दॅट. आणि मग तो सगळं ते लिहायचा, आणि मग त्याच्यावर चित्र आपण प्रिंट केलेले आहेत की जिथे हे सगळे पोस्टर्स आम्ही गावागावात लावले आणि आम्ही एक गावाचं छान नेटवर्क फॉर्म केलं. वी हॅव अंडरस्टूड थ्री मेन प्रॉब्लेम्स विच हॅव बीन फेस्ड बाय वल्चर डिक्लाइन प्रोसेस. त्याच्यामध्ये पहिला प्रॉब्लेम होता वल्चर नॉट गेटिंग फूड, इनएडिक्वेट फूड ऑर ऍबसेन्स ऑफ फूड, इट वॉज द बिगेस्ट प्रॉब्लेम. कारण डायक्लोफिनॅकचा आपल्याकडे तसा प्रॉब्लेम नव्हता, नाहीतर मग ही पण गिधाड सगळी खलास झाली असती, मेली असती, गेली असती. पण गावागावांमध्ये जे ग्रामस्वच्छता अभियान निघालं, त्या अभियानामुळे सगळ्यांना गावकऱ्यांना गोरं पुरायच्या ऑर्डर्स आल्या, GR. सो GR हॅव बीन पब्लिश वेअर कार्कसेस शुड बी डम्प्ड टू रिस्पेक्टिव्ह विलेजेस विलेज एरिया ऑर दॅट कॅम्पस. सो अशा प्रकारे वल्चर डिडंट गेट प्रॉपर फूड, ते जरी डायक्लोफेनॅक इन्फेक्टेड असेल तरी फूडच त्यांना भेटलं नाही, कारण ते गाडाला सुरुवात झाली. सो दॅट फूड वॉज डम्प्ड. सो इन ऍबसन्स ऑफ दॅट फूड दे फेस्ड स्टार्वेशन, देअर चिक फेस्ड स्टार्वेशन प्रॉब्लेम, अँड सेकंडली द ट्रीज हॅबिटॅट कन्स्ट्रक्शन, हॅबिटॅट जे आहे ते तुम्ही गेल्या 20 वर्षात बघितलं तर पुण्या मुंबई किंवा अनेक लोकांनी ह्या कोकणातल्या प्रॉपर्टीज घेतल्यात, मोठ्या दरीतली जंगलं घेतलीत मोठी मोठी, आणि खूप स्वस्तात त्यांना जागा मिळाल्या. आणि त्यामुळे काय झालं, गावकऱ्यांना बिचाऱ्यांना पोरं शहरात जात असल्यामुळे बरीच वर्ष त्यांच्या नशिबी कष्ट आणि कुठल्याच हे नसल्यामुळे जमिनी विकणं हा एक त्यांच्या समोर पर्याय असून त्यांनी त्या विकल्या, आणि त्या लोकांनी प्रचंड बेसुमार कत्तल केली. आणि 2-3 वेळ याच्यातून ही कत्तल झाली, ती म्हणजे बेकरीसाठी लागणारं लाकूड, कोळशासाठी लागणारं लाकूड, शिकारीसाठी जंगल तोड आणि जंगल जाण झालं ते, अशा प्रकारे ओव्हरऑल या सगळ्या हॅबिटेट डिस्ट्रक्शन हा सेकंड प्रॉब्लेम होता. आणि फीडिंग ग्राउंड वर फूड नसल्यामुळे ते जिथे जिथे मायग्रेट होत होते.
सॉरी टू इंटरप्ट यू, देर आर टू रिक्वेस्ट फ्रॉम द व्ह्यूअर्स दॅट स्पीक मोर इन इंग्लिश एज दे कॅन फॉलो मराठी.
येस येस, आय एम टॉकिंग इंग्लिश. येस
येस,
थोडं जर आता मध्येच मराठी.
येस येस, थँक्यू.
एव्हरीवन दे हॅव लॉस्ट देअर फूड बिकॉज ऑफ दिस विलेज क्लीन मोमेंट. and which have been produced by a collector or on the governing body on that platform, and loss of habitat, and third one is about the increasing temperature or whatever the other factors are. Next slide, please. So this is the Vulture Study Center, research center, where we are conducting all these activities and do research and do noting all their population data and everything. So this is ultimately the tall trees forest, typically endemic tall trees of Mangifera indica. Then you can see the tall trees of sativa, means sativa nija hai tiek. Then behda and all evergreen patches you can see. Next slide, please. So such a forest should be preserved. So amala ashi apeksha hoti. You can see a very beautiful sneak view of this valley forest. Me atta I am on the top of 600 to 800 feet height, and where you can see waterfall as a valley forest hai, and that waterfall keep all this vegetation green. So the water holes are very important, and the water holding capacity of these roots and all the shoots and then to the soil, it is very on high level, which is keeping all this valley, and you can see the area with lush green carpet. And the tall tree you can see, which is of a height of 180 feet. This tree is called as the Shedab in Marathi, or One Bend in Marathi, and in English it is called as Tetramelus nudiflora. So this is the tree where the vultures they used to roost, because it acts as a tower for watch, or to keep watch on surrounding area up to, you can see, 8 kilometer or 6 kilometer. To that view or vision. Next slide, please. So protecting such a forest is very important. So what to do? Convey villages that the forest of reserve act or the sacred forest, it is belongs to them first. That property is though registered with forest department, it is firstly belongs to villagers, local villagers. So that is very important to give them their right to keep protected forest attached to that village or whatever, or nearby that village. So to create awareness, we have done Gaav Jodo Abhiyan. So these villagers, when they took banners or they took the party having walk to the next village, like rallies to the neighbor village, the neighboring villagers, they understand very easily the language of their brothers and the relatives which are coming from neighboring villages and visit them. They have very tremendous respect with neighboring those villagers. So Tumija, when you started your work specifically in every area, and when you will create awareness to the neighboring villages concerned with your project area village, so if you enroll villagers in your activities, and when they will walk with you, then you will get 110% result good, concrete. Next slide, please. So these are the villagers of Chirgaav, and these are the villagers of Nanemachi, which have took the banner, and we have walked from Nanemachi to 6 kilometer. These all villagers walk with me and our SISCAP NGO, and with aim able to create awareness about vulture and forest to the neighboring villages. So the neighboring villages, they immediately understood the issues, and also they get confident if the whole villages, if they willingly visit us, and they are telling us to keep our forest conserve and to conserve our birds and animals, then they immediately agreed or ready to do the further movements. So it is very important to to consider all these villages. So your emotional bondings as well as your caretaking, whatever the features are there, whatever the activities are there, those should be heart touching to those local people. Then and there, the local people gives you very good response. Next slide, please. So then for 3.5 years, we have done the survey of throwing the carcasses to different grounds. For that, we have covered 178 villages from Mahad Tehsil, then Srivardhan Tehsil, Masala, Mangav, this four tehsil from area, we have analyzed 178 villages for nearly 3.5 years to search the exact place where the vultures hovers and they can be landed for having their feast or having their food. So you can see the food is dropped behind the villages. Me in front of, I'm talking in front of those villages group, that is the leaders from or the head from different you know group. The young personalities, those are from cricket or some other groups. The temple like group are there, or the other groups of the workers are there. So all they visited with me on ground, and we have analyzed whether the vultures are landing or they are just taking their food or not. So it was the previous time, which was very tedious business. Actually, villagers, they have argues with us that if the vultures, they fails to have their food, means to eat the carcasses, which have been dropped near our village on feeding ground, we supposed to take that all remaining. If the vultures are not visiting, then whatever the decay carcasses is there, that should be again, we supposed to lift and dump in the longer distance area. So that was typically tedious task, which have been we have worked for nearly 3.5 years. And then the villagers, they habitual to our nature, our enthusiasm, and they get ready to keep and to clean by their own. Next slide, please. So it is very hard sometimes. This is the picture of Danimachi. In cliff, you can see the white dots where the cliff nestlers, longbill vultures are nesting. So you can see by long distance, by naked eye too, some white dots in such a cliffs. And then if you see binocular, by using binocular, if you have close observations, then you easily can see a spot of stone-like bird present in that groove or in that gap-like line, black line. So this observation could be done only by spot scope or 10 by 50 binocular of good quality. Next slide, please. So these are, this is the office of Nanimachi, where the cliff nesters longbill are nesting. And he is Mr. Mahamunkar, Sudhakar Mahamunkar. Now he is no more. So this slide, which have been taken in 2004, and the office is still there, and which is monitored and run by the next village head, Sudhir Mahamunkar. Just a couple of week back, we had meeting with him, and we have count the longbill vultures population with all villagers and our expertise. Next slide, please. So this is the typical feeding ground. When we put the carcasses were eaten by or finished by the vultures, and then we collect the carcasses in in bag or in a pack like package, and then after counting them, if you see the picture, we have dropped within 2 months 18 carcasses. 18 carcasses are there. 18 carrions are there, you can see. And those have been counted, and then they were dumped or they were crushed and dumped to the farmers or the areas where mango farms or the coconut farms are there. That is act as a good manure tree. So this cleaning process or to protect that feeding ground from the dogs or the other cattle which are used to chewing that bones, it is very important to protect that area by having fence. Next. So vulture feeding ground. Now this is the main threat. This down valley, you can see this is the colony of whiteback vulture where we are working now, and all the losing battle, you can see. This is the site of one of the biggest politicians in our area, Raigad district, who have his own land, and which was about to destruct, and we put petition on that process where it was blocked or it was being under a stay for nearly 8 years. But later on, again, the work have been started, and now a beautiful resort have set up there, and rest of the land, it was being plotted for selling the plots for house building or any other purposes. So we are losing this all topmost forest in clock hours because it is private, it is jungle. So from beginning, I was just telling to many people, many expertise that that this all forest, it is private land. So please purchase that land and make it under Conservation Act. So I told BNHS too, I told many other agencies too. So rather to took the bird into cage like Pinjor or some Assam in that area where the Konkani this bird that is the vultures, they have been taken in the cage, and the in cage breeding activity was done by many scientists. So actually we are against of that. We were simply focused on in situ breeding techniques or methodology, where the forest first have been under it should be under monitor and it should be preserved or conserved, and then rest to that the species. It should be all done by natural process, because all these are scavengers. The scavengers and the hunters, all these the raptors, these chain of animals and birds, those are having the ability of facing competition to catch their prey and all that. And this all technique, having their jump to catch that speed and all, catching that prey, whatever the process are there, it has been taught by their parents as well as their colonial, their all the members. So that process is not taking place in cage breeding center, where the animal only supplied by food and in a very short that distance is used to flap his wings. Whereas in the nature, the first flight birds, they are getting a height of 2,000 feet height distance, you may say, from ground level. They are taking flight, and then they are taught by their teachers or their all colonial members. And they have good community communications and behavioral patterns I have observed since 20 years. Next slide, please. So this is the major threat of destruction, forest destruction or ecosystem. So this is the, again, Terminalia bellarica. This is the roosting trees. Though the roosting trees, those are seen dry and leafless, those are very important. Even if the trees somehow died, the branches of that, all the dry branches, they are holding the various populations of the birds, like woodpeckers. They used to nest in the dry branches that holds. So these all raptors, they are always roosting on such branches. Even sometimes they used to nest. So this is all young populations, you can see. Identification of juvenile populations. So for the very first time, we have seen 6 to 9 birds. They flew for the first time and they occupy the place. They roost for nearly 1.5 month. They used to fly to the nearby forest, and again for roosting, they are occupied that treetop. So it is seen that once it is fixed by these juveniles or the parental population, a roosting tree, that roosting tree remain forever in that typical area for their all colonial roosting sites or roosting purpose. Next. So next. This is typical, again, the parental population. You can see, this is very important thing. We have dropped the carcasses very first time, and then we observed the birds are coming or they are reaching to the food, but they are helpless to eat that food. Then we came to know that the king vulture was having the ability to tear, to take the tear. So king vulture used to take the tear of nearly neck portion or somehow the portion of ribs, and to the portion of eye, that skin. And by past, by past discussion with the old villagers, you can see the senior person, when we discuss the things, they told me that in previous time, the king was supposed to come first. When king arrived, the long-bill vultures and white-back vultures, they are, they are giving at that time the way to the king vulture to have those tears on that bite. So this is all what Raja ala ki mag teji praja bajula vaychi ani te pahile Raja tala chos marnar ani mag hi sagi praja teji khanar. So ashi stories tumhala sagikade aikala mile. So that story is really was in truth. we have lost our last king vulture from Raigarh district in 1987. So it was noted by observers, and then later on we don't have a king vulture in our district, as well as it was observed to the border of Nagpur and Madhya Pradesh, Kanha National Park, to the Penj area. Next. त्यामुळे टीयर घेणं फार महत्वाचं असतं. सो टीयर इज व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट. सो वी सपोज टू रिमूव्ह द स्कीम. सो आमचा हे सगळी टीम आहे, योगेश आहे, चिंतन आहे, चिराग आहे, श्रद्धा जोशी आहे, ऑल अवर ट्री मेंबर्स 43 मेंबर्स आर देअर, ज्याच्यामध्ये स्टुडंट्स आहेत, मीन्स फिमेल आहेत, मेल्स आहेत, आमच्याकडे असं काही जेंडर हे नाही आहे, बट ऑल आर वर्किंग व्हेरी एन्थुझियास्टिकली. दे टूक टीयर ऑफ द स्कीन अँड दे एक्सपोज द कार्कसेस अँड देन द लॉन्गबेल अँड व्हाईटबॅक वल्चर्स दे आर फीडिंग. And they finish the carcasses within a couple of hours. So after with the beginning of our work was with only 22 population. आम्ही जेव्हा कामाची सुरुवात केली, when we have started our work in 2000, there were only 22 population where we have started work with only two nests left. And now the population is rise to 350. It was count taken in 2019, and there were 84 nests. So don nest from two nest the population goes to 84 nest, and from 22 the population goes to 350. So it took a 21 year constancy work or the work which is very keenly operated by our group members, all our team members, all our donors, whatever the helping or well wishers hands were there. Because of all the collective hands, this work had gone to succeed. So this is the jeep, or you may say the pickup, where we carried the carcasses. We have formed the network of villagers where we get informed if the cow or any livestock is dead, and our all members, they are taking the on rent such a pickup van. And they are just reaching to the villages and collect that all carcasses to brought it to the feeding ground of Chirgaon. So somewhere the Chirgaon, from Chirgaon, the Nagotne or Palit is 92 or 98 kilometer distance. So if, even if we are getting the food from Nagotne, then from the Pain or Alibag area, we are bringing that food to the Chirgaon or Chandore feeding ground. To the south side, if you are getting food from Chiplun, then from Khed or from Mandangad area, we also used to bring that. We are really keen for searching of such a food, and we are not leaving that chance to get that all food to drop it on dumping ground or on feeding ground. So this is the feeding ground where that food has been brought. So the expense of transport and later the other expenses are there, which are of high cost, and that had been generated. It is very in need of time to get collected that much amount. Next slide, please. So this is how the carcasses are living behind. You can see the population very clearly about whiteback vultures, and whatever the other colors are there, which are whitest and socks like on their legs, there are plumage, white plumage. So those vultures, they are from Rajasthan and Gujarat. So I have been traveling to many parts of India, as well as to foreign countries in for Cinereus vulture to Russia, southern part of Tuva region, as well as the region of this Mongolia. So I'm very much thankful for ILA Foundation, Dr. Satish Pandey, who have been launch the project of pelagic bird survey, and I've been connected with his NGO from that point, and he have conducted the ARRCN conference in Pune, where I got access to the Denver Zoo. He introduced me with Denver Zoo and told a story about conservation activities. And the Denver Zoo from USA, that team, he have selected me for a radio telemetry program of the Cinereus vulture, which have been done in 2014. I've been there in Mongolia to tag Cinereus vulture, which is a winter visitor to our area. So on feeding ground, once these all scavengers, that they are confident about getting food at that place, they used to visit. So many times we are observing griffon vultures. Last week we observed 6 griffon vultures. They are there staying in our area of Sivadar and Masla. where they used to feed on these feeding grounds. So these migrants are always, if they are get confident about food, they are not losing that place. So they are keeping their stay for longer time, for 2.5 months. So we, according to this, we came to know about, if such a case is there, then we are changing the ground towards northern area, to Pali or some other area, to 80 kilometers, so that the population should fluctuate and it should fly, it should go or search to the another area. We should not keep them as like pet, you know. Next slide, please. So this is the promote of healthy gene, you know. You can see the wing, like you know, one of the builder, bodybuilder, who is just staying on stage and just roaring his arms and you know, just giving challenges to the frontier. Just come fight with me, and if you are able to fight with me, means if you have strong gene, strong muscles, then and there you are allowed to eat food. So during this feeding technique or during this feeding process, it is, you know, it is very very you know, a curious moment to observe, like a ceremony is taking place, like the population gathered, then the healthy population or strong population, they always keep front, then they stand on the carcasses, they are putting the droppings and sign their presence, then they just asking for fighters to fight with them, and then after selection of, or after having the feast for these all you know, good healthy population, then they allow the other population to feed on that. So healthy population should promote first. It is the law of nature, which is, you can see on feeding ground very clearly. But they are keeping the food for juvenile as well as the sub-adults too. They are also thinking about their community members. They are not you know, having ability of greedy like humans. Especially, I'm really, when humans are making comments that your nature is like that of vulture. Means gidhar asal ki tujha swabhav hai. Gidhars or vultures are not like that. They are thinking very deeply about their community members. They are not selfish like humans. Next slide, please. So in such a way, every bird should get food. And you can see this is slide which I've been taken by one of my foreign friend, Emma. I'm very much thankful that she was here. And she shot this in 2005, where the population of vultures from 22 to goes on 35. You can count very clearly, there are 35 birds. So we were really very happy to see this population, where we have counted 14 nests at that time, and only, you know, 8 to 9 young birds we have seen, and rest of other population, 1 to 2 birds, they have, I think, from rest of other pockets we were in search of. Next slide, please. So in such a way, while on feeding, you must have to observe the keen smaller things. By these two pictures, you can see very clearly. When we expose the scene, that we expose the skin of the animal from, you know, stomach or the body part of vent and lateral side, or the arms of that carcass, it was, we left to you know, remove the skin of all head. So you can see the head skin is remain as it is. Then from that moment, we learned that again we want to remove the skin of head also, so that the bird can eat also whatever the bone marrow, the other things or the muscles from head too. So you can see you can compare the removed skin of head. It is well finished by the vultures, and where the skin is there, the skin is not able to remove by long bill or wide-eyed vultures. They are unable to take tear, and the skin is remain as it is. So it is, it will create some nuisance, but the exposed, you know, the skull, it is sterile by sunrise, and it is become dry, and whatever the other muscles or the bone marrow left behind, it is eaten by insects or larvas. Next slide, please. So vultures are doing, actually, vultures are clean up crow, or crew, you may say, clean up crew. One clean up crew, if it flew and flocked on a carcass, it can finish within a couple of hours. He is Mr. Rajwadkar Sahib, or the RFO, who is from Thane. and the rest of forest officials, Gornak, then Thale, and then the other visitors are there. This is very important slides I'm showing you. The dug or ditch, whatever the debris you can see behind them or to the left side of them. So I was informed by monitor team that the forest officers, they are digging the ditches to the core zone of the that area. So I told and asked to Rajwarkar sir, who is RFO, that what's going on in the core zone of that vulture nesting sites or the reserve area. He told me that we are building watch towers over there. So I told him, I request him that please build up the tower to the village site where the human movement is there. If we can keep the core zone safe for breeding success or safe for vultures, then the breeding will be good. That is shy bird and all that. And Rajwarkar had took deep interest and he settled all that or shifted that all tower project to the nearby site. This land is given by Mr. Bare, who is a local villager. He donated that land to forest officials and the tower is built up there. So you can see the watch tower is there from where the vultures can be watched. So no any other, with us, our team, also escape team is not allowed to enter in the forest unless there is no any critical problem have been observed. So we are keeping that forest very untouched. So to keep untouched that forest, to take the care of human interference, it is very important. So in such a way, we keep monitoring during breeding season all this area. And in this way, the forest officials are also very much enthusiastic and very much interested to take this conservation action to the upper level. Next, please. So if you have good relations with these, then there is the second thing. You are not supreme, no error. I suppose this very sincerely, because this every second die will give you definitely or surely the another thing or the different thing in the forest. So he is Mr. Kavale, who is holding in right hand his camera. He is expert in botany. He know everything from plant, trees, shrubs, everything. And he is Mr. Vaibhav Deshmukh, who is well-known birder from Alibag. I respect both of them. Whenever I call them on phone, they used to visit our site and also they help to, having the data from these all biodiversity, aspects of shrubs, aspect of ferns, everything, and about the rest of other bird life. So we have counted 224 species of trees under guidance of Mr. Kavale and Suniti Dharap, who is from PAIN, our CISCAP member, family member, and Dr. Vaibhav Deshmukh. He is bird expert. He has also done a lot of work and sought out many birds and checklist of birds. So we have counted nearly 320 plus birds. Those are visiting or those are present in this forest. Especially we have the good species of owls, species of hornbills, then these raptors, from hawk eagle to white eye buzzards and sparrowhawks, and then crested hawk eagles, the raptors like these vultures. Next slide, please. So whenever you are just concentrating on single species, you must have to count the biodiversity for one purpose. You can see in this picture, there is a climber, which is thorny climber, called as Sagar Gota in Marathi. So this climber is covering slowly the nest where the chick, you can see. The chick was injured by the thorns of that climber. And it was badly, locked in that thorn, which was observed by Sushant. And he informed me at that time, we climb up the tree and we cut down that all climber, spread branch and just clean that nest cover. And then took that bird to a safe zone. And we took care to the vulture, caring center. And after 8 to 10 days, we again kept that bird into the nest. Next slide, please. So one must understood the natural threat. So this is female, which is on the nest, and you know, she accept our chick, or you know, say chickling that time, or you know, say that grown up fledgling at that time. So this is what the case where birds are, or that parents are very keen to having the touch with their or caring their you know, chicklings or the that subadult or juveniles. So unless it is not standing, or it is not naturally start its life feeding or protecting itself or doing all activities normally. Next slide, please. So this is the case where you have, you want to observe the natural as well as artificial threats. This is the slide where I show you. I'm trying to show you the top portion. It is the tall mango tree. We're on tree top. That whatever the you know, bracket or the platform is there, there the pair have been built up that this nest. This nest I am observing since 16 to 18 years. It was second nest. Means two nests were there previously. We were observed in 2000, and from that up to last cyclone, it was there. But during cyclone, this all tall tree, it was fallen down, and I lost my first sight this nest, which I was love very much. I was so affect, you know, so, I was so touched with this nest. Next slide, please. So it was heart touching moment where I also taken this picture. You can see exact the bigger size of these juvenile. You can see in the nest. After a couple of week, it will fly. It will take its first flight, and the parents are sitting to the side where they are always keeping watch to that juveniles or the nest bird. Next slide, please. So this is the late evening I took the photo. In the morning, after a couple of weeks, you see the foliage of branches have been changed. The new leaves have been come out, and it was the time to take its first flight. So this juvenile was really happy to see the direction of the parent. They have been told that please follow the path of western zone. Maybe they were teaching that juvenile to see the thermal ball, the thermal, you know, beam of hot air. Once the air is hot, it starts to come up very speedily and form a beam-like structure. And it is very clearly seen by these flying or hovering birds. And then they used to fly and catch that beams, and they go up and up in the air, like hovering centrally, making circle over and over. They get a certain height, and then after getting thousands of height, they leave that beam to travel for next thermal ball. So in this way, they used to fly the pattern of using thermal ball, these hot air balloons, and by that technique, they you know, very least they are losing their energy. They are storing their energy. So all these theories are all the things maybe the parents they are telling, and very keenly the juvenile is taking all the things, listening the things. Next slide, please. This is the first very, very, you know, it was the moment, joyful moment when we seen the population. The bird were 19. The total count of nest, it was Chirgaon that time highest. Up to 22 nests we have counted at that time, and from 22 nests, 19 nests have been brooded, and the newly take first flight, all that group, it flew to having their prominent roost, their traditional roost of the tree top of newly that Tetramelus nudiflora tree. I like that tree very much. I love that tree very much. It is very tall tree and huge branches it has. A very beautiful net of small branches, and that has, you know, those are very stout. Those are very powerful branch, you know, branching that all flimsy network. So they are holding that bird very, you know, strongly. So these are all young population we observed. Next slide, please. So this is the largest number, and which we got very satisfied. The Chirgaon River started from a spring, very little spring, turns into waterfall, fall for 2 to 3 times, goes to different villages of Chirgaon to Masla, and Masla to all the creek of, you know, Dighi. And alas, there is to the Borli or Dighi, this creek region where you can see the mangrove, beautiful mangrove, the network of mangrove you can see. So there are 22 to 34 species of mangrove we have surveyed. So the river is completed. It's, you know, a path. It's traveling. It's life. And, you know, when the river get open to the coastal area or the creek area, and it has the cover of, its bank has the cover of such a lush green carpet of this mangrove, that river is very happy to have such a babies, you know. So that is also, that is, you know, well known for its character of, you know, motherhood. So it is like a big mother of all these river, you know, ecosystem on the bank of river, whatever the villages are there, who are dependent on the fresh water or whatever the tidal zone of the river is giving them, the money or the product, whatever it is. So it likes a big mother, you know. So I have deep respect for this Chilga River. Next. So we were having connected with Bhau Kadare's project of turtle at Divyagar, and where we have appointed two volunteers, and those volunteers were Padave. Their surname is Padave, and the Padave sons, very, you know, they have the time with us, they are spending, and now they have grown up very well. But this slide is very olden slide. They collected the crabs within 2 hours from the same creek. So whatever the economy stand, you can count those crab cost. It is about 1,500 to 2,000. So very good economy is sustained by the river ecosystem. Next slide, please. So tradition and customs give you such a festivals like Velas or like in Srivardhan, Divyagar, we're conducting these turtle festivals where the economy runs, the tourist comes and watch this. But we are against of wildlife, you know, tourism. I don't like personally wildlife tourism. So I don't like to show the vultures or any other endangered species to visitors or the tourists and to earn money for the same villages. We have different projects. We should go for that. We should avoid as much as tourism to the poor zone or poor places. Rather, that tourism will sustain our stand in a different way. That topic we'll discuss next time. Next slide, please. So this is the beautiful leopard. The, you know, we lost this majesty in 2011. It was trapped by the poachers, and I was really many times taken and follow signs of his pug marks. I was really deeply touched with his pug marks, his movement. Sometimes for a couple of times I observed his keens moving from, you know, the dark bush. At one time I remember when the leopard was sitting on that waterfall. Actually it was taking the bath and it was, you know, lying in the water, that waterfall line. And then after checking my sign, my presence or my movement, the animal went away to a different way. But I followed his path, its pug marks, and the weight line of whatever the water it was left from, you know. So I was very much sad at that time. Next slide, please. So losing battle is very much, you know, losing battle is really a hard time now for us. This is the pangolin, again, the endangered species, which is the India's largest pangolin. Within a couple of years only, from Srivardhan, Masala, and from Khed, you can see various news are there on network by putting to the Google. You can see from these three area, nearly 18 to 20, these pangolins have been poached, have been killed. Their scales have been trafficked. Their skins have been trafficked. The animal have been trafficked. Next slide, please. This is not the subject of discussion now for this time to the vulture. This was very first slide taken in 1999, where I observed first time on Vadgar Plateau when I was coming from one of my friend's school after the program of 15th August flag hosting program. I was on the top of that Vadgar Plateau and noticed somehow 22 birds and got very satisfied. And then I followed a last bird, which took me to the area of nesting sites of Chirgaon, where we launched our first study center, study research center. Next slide, please. So this is the roosting tree, and this is the view where you can see the Masala Creek in front of you and the Divagar line, which is got blurred in the moist bloom of the all the wave from coming all the air coming from coastal line. Next slide, please. Every record should be taken grant to forest department. You should note everything to forest department, and then see what is the role useful for next generation, how they are acting on your past records. So if you keep past records that those animals were there, the next generation will find out desperately for that presence of that animal, and they will get, and they will definitely do some conservation work. So your records of every creature found in that area, it should done with forest department. Next slide, please. So next is our young generation. This is my very favorite subject, because once you mold, these are molding minds. If you mold them towards conservation, you will get the statue, the ready statue of really conserving minds, you can see. So all the school, all these team, I'm taking them to plantation, making, trees or collecting seeds, teaching them to identify trees, and then birds and all that things. So when you will make them knowledgeable, they will know their soil beauty, the soil things, living things, and then they will confront to stand like the moment of Greta Thunberg. So Greta Thunberg at the age of 14 and 15, she started, and now her moment spread worldwide. At the age of 16, she delivered the lecture on climate, climate conference, which was held in US. And we all were, just shivered by her words, and the tears come out by her, appeal to conserve the deadline of this vanishing beautiful world of our nature. Next. So these are the purposeful. I'm showing the Pali Gad Sudhagad, which is nearest to Mumbai. We are observing long distance the nest of vultures, which are in the cliff. Here, the spotscope is needed. Our NGO, SISCAPE, is needed in need of such a devices, which will support us for observation as well as to take our eye to or inside to the nest. So inadequate funding we have. So we appeal through this slide that please support us technically if you have funding. Next slide, please. These are the coconut trees. The coconut trees are, the conflict is going on. When the whiteback vultures, they are using coconut trees to the Srivardhan side for their nesting purpose or breeding purpose. The trees are, broken their branches by some activity. The trees after 2 to 3 years, you can see dead. So in such a way, the nesting trees are become dead after 2 to 3 years. Sometimes they are become dead after 1 year. Whenever the bird is coming towards the nest, he is used to land to the another tree, which is used for landing purpose. So all whatever the 6 to 7 kg load, after having gravity of 9.8, whatever the force from thousand of feet, it makes that branch loosen when it sharply glide and landed landing to the branch of that coconut. So the branch get loosened and then loses and fallen down. So in this way, after losing the branches, the tree become barren, exposed, and it become dead. So that tree, then roosting tree and nesting tree, the three types of trees are conflict by the use of these vultures in the coconut farms. Next slide, please. So we are in seek of, we took a meeting with Srivardhan head and all the mayors of our Nagar Sevak of all that city, urban area. And we took the issue of all these farmers, coconut farmers, that they should be given by compensation by some cost, repairable cost to each farmer. So the meeting was held a couple of years back after COVID and after this cyclone. Again, there is a vast drop in the nesting sites as each farmer have lost his 80% of trees, tall trees, coconut trees. And even though they are supporting for nesting purposes. So now for this year, we have announced the program that taking, Dattak Yojana, Nalacha Jhaad Kiva Tya Yacha Jhaad Jaye. So Asha Prakare Tumhi, you can take that tree as a parental care or as a parent, you can take care of that tree. So we are announcing 5,000 to 10,000 to donate each tree to the farmer. So also we are, doing the conservation in the same manner, because from governing body till date, they don't have given by a good amount of, compensation. Only 250 rupees have been given by forest department as well as the Nagar Parishad, and which is very least amount, as the tree are of 60 to 80 years old. And so the cost should be 5 to 10,000 minimum. I think so. We have taken minimum cost. And so that donation should be, announced or collected to give to farmer. Next slide, please. Then and there, the conservation work will play important. Rest to other subject as rescue and rehabilitation. We have rescued 11 birds, 11 different type of, white-back vultures, long-billed vultures, or the Himalayan griffon vulture, you can see to the right side, which we have rescued. We have kept it for 3.5 months. Each day, we were feed them 1.5 kg kilo meat. You can see the cost. Each bird, while on rehabilitation, takes nearly 20,000 to 30,000 meat. Then other taking care methodologies there. So rescue and rehabilitation centers we have in Mahad as well as to Srivardhan and Masala, where we are taking care. And you see how the villagers, boys, also they are taking care of that injured bird. So this is very close relation of each of us, from soil to from SISCAP, our members, our well-wishers, to the conservation issues. We are very heartily touching and connected with all these work to conserve each and every part where would we have get chance to do our service best. Next slide, please. So thanking for us. And what is the future? The future is seen. This is the toddlers, very sweet, very gaudy. They're in, you can see their t-shirts and all their colors, their cheek and their emotions, how they're taking care. You see how they are taking care in absence of me. When I was leaving that bird on their responsibility, these all villages of Chirgaon, these all chote chote bacche, they are taking the care. Even if they are frightening, they are used to play with the bird, So this is how the conservation it should be. So in this way, I think I want to stop here because the time is not permitting. I have a lot of things to share with you, but whatever I talk with you, I don't know how much you have understood by 11th hour, the speak or spoken, whatever I think, the elaborations and the label I use, the words and all that. After a long period, I have talked with you, the chance to see you. Any questions or any things, whatever you want to ask me, you can ask me.
Yes. Thank you, sir, for giving this very informative talk. Many viewers have commented the same, that the talk was very informative and work is very appreciable. So on behalf of Purnam, I congratulate the work of SISCAP. While you are talking, your passion for the work was reflecting very much, and I'm sure viewers were very well connected to the conservation to the problem roots of the roots yeah. for the yes for the problem. And you very well said about community participation. I think every Indian conservation
attends to that.
Yes, every activity for the conservation of environment requires community participation very much, because as a community we are part of environment and we have to do we have to participate in such activities. Yes. What your NGO is also doing. So I think due to lack of time, we will have only two questions right now, but viewers can comment, can post their questions in comment later also.
If you forward questions to my phone number by SMS on WhatsApp,
yes,
I will answer them. I will personally talk with them.
Yes, yes.
So very warm welcome from our NGO system for everybody who is keeping enthusiastic views and who want to or wish to join with us by voluntary or by taking participation in any view, all it is welcome. And also I'm very much thankful to your Purnam that you have given me this such a break, and I've spoken this all hardest work whatever we've been doing. Thank you.
Yes, I like to mention about the what we talked before the webinar. I haven't mentioned it in your introduction, so I would like to tell the viewers that BBC Marathi have
yes
made the documentary about the world.
My interview was held by Sadi Sachcha Batmya, matlab Marathi news.
Okay.
Doordarshan news. My okay. radio telecast program where telecasting or on Doordarshan for so many times from Neha Khare, who have taken my interview for so many times on different subjects.
Okay.
And we are working on egrets conservations, eagle conservations. Mm-hmm. Manishri Bapat, she has worked with me on eagle, sea eagle conservation project.
Okay.
So I'm very much thankful for her for that. Mm-hmm. She has joined, and she really sincerely worked with me. Then the forest birds also are there, and again the sacred forest and the many projects are there where we are working. So you can visit us after this COVID. And okay. We will see, and we will understand, and we will take part, and we'll do our work jointly.
Yes, surely. I'm going to ask about that. What are the research opportunities for the students in the vulture conservation or in general conservation of?
Of course, of course. There are opportunities. There are the subjects where we can see the monitoring subjects are there. We are in need of a sincere monitoring team, which can monitor. We have eight regions. This Uttaragarh, Nanimachi, one area, one Varangi, which is behind exact to the Raigad Fort, the Taminighat area, the area of Pali region. This is for long-billed vulture especially. Then to the forest bird, that is the whiteback vulture, which are tree nestlers. Those are the Sirivardhan, Masala Chirga, Wadgar, and Khamgav areas. Where we are desperately in need of sincere volunteers, where okay. they can come and do the monitoring work. And also we need to communicate or to get information from informants from different villages, that the information of about the carcasses.
Okay.
So the four tahsil, each mm-hmm. tahsil has 110 villages. So 400 or 300 villages we have connected, and it is out of our hand to collect or to get connected with each villager. So if you are really interested to have connections of all the villagers regularly, whether there are carcasses, then we will inform by that carcasses, and we will manage our team to collect that. So that is very important. And okay. About the awareness program too. Yes.
Okay.
So sure. These are the things which we can work together, and we'll okay. manage that.
Okay. So I ask viewers to join this initiative. I think passionate volunteers are needed for yes. this work. So thank you once again, sir, for taking us into your very nice journey, inspiring journey. And also I thank you for the for associating with Purnam Ecovision Foundation.
Yes, thank you.
Yes, I would like to tell some brief about Purnam Ecovision Foundation. So Purnam is working since last 8 years in waste management and environment. So 5 projects we are running: fabric upcycling, sanitary napkin disposal, e-waste and plastic waste management, green consultancy, where consultation regarding rainwater harvesting and composting at society level is given. Then awareness initiatives, so various awareness activities run through the through our organization. So I would also like to invite you all to take part in these activities for the betterment of the environment. Thank you all.
Sure, sure.
And thank you, sir, once again.
One of my question, why yes. to save vultures for viewers? So let them communicate with you. And okay. Thank you.
Yes. Okay. Thank you.
Yes. Welcome.